Hello, good morning everybody. In this video we are going to implement the wander and enclosure strings. We will make the character move randomly inside the defined area. This string is useful, for example, with characters that don't have anything to do until the player approaches them. Before starting coding, let me explain a little how the wander string works. We create a cycle in front of the character. Then, we add the radius of the cycle, with a random angle, to the vector to the cycle, and we obtain the desired velocity. We will modify the angle a little every frame, so the character won't change direction all of a sudden. With that said, it's time to start coding. Let's start declaring a pair of constants. The wander cycle radius constant stores the radius of the cycle. It will influence the turning speed of the character. Create another constant called wander randomness that stores the maximum amount of variation the angle of the wander radius can have every frame. The greater the randomness, the greater the direction variation the character will experience. Now, create a variable with the name wander angle to store the angle of the wander cycle and initialize it to 0. Also, we will need a boolean variable to store whether the player is wandering or not. You can make it an export variable to change its value easily from the editor. Create the wander string function. Firstly, set the value of the wander angle variable using the random range function. The angle will be between the actual angle minus the randomness constant and the actual angle plus the randomness constant. After that, we calculate the vector to the target multiplying the normalized velocity by the max speed, and we store the result in a variable. In another variable, store the desired velocity, the vector to the cycle plus the cycle radius rotated by the wander angle. Note that I put the radius on the x component of the vector. This will cause the character to move to the right when the angle is 0. And at the end of the function, return the desired velocity minus the actual velocity. This function will randomize the direction of the bro using the wander angle. The wander angle will be the new direction of the bro. He will rotate his velocity vector to attempt to match the wander angle. Go to the physics process function and add an if after declaring the steering variable. Check if the wandering variable is true. If so, add the wander string. Elsewise, add the rest of the strings we did in the previous videos. This could be done with the state machine, but I don't want to make it too complex. The wander string is all ready, but the result of the random range function to determine the angle will always be the same. We have to randomize the seed to make it different every time we play the game. Add the randomize function at the init function of the script of the root node of your game, or wherever you want, but it should be called once at the start of the game. Now you can play the game and the character will move randomly around the map. But we have a problem. The bro can go beyond the camera limits. We must create a new string to limit his movement area, the enclosure string. So, back at the character script, add an export variable called enclosure zone, and store in it a rect2, with the zone where you want the bro to wander. The rect2 has two vector2. The first one is the position where the zone starts, and the second one is the dimension of the zone, the width and the height. Create a new function that returns a vector2 for the enclosure string. Inside the function, declare a variable called desired velocity and initialize it to a zero vector. Now, for every direction, check if the character is out of the box. If so, increase the desired velocity by 1 in the opposite direction. After checking every direction, normalize the desired velocity and multiply it by the maximum speed. If the desired velocity is not a zero vector, set the wander angle to the direction of the desired velocity, to avoid the bro going in the exact same direction after entering again the zone limit. In that case, return the desired velocity minus the velocity. If the desired velocity is a zero vector, return a zero vector. To summarize, if the bro oversteps the limits of the enclosure area, we create a force to make it turn inside the zone again. Oh, I get an error because I forgot to put some components of the velocity vector. So let's fix it. To apply the steering at the function we just implemented, do the steering variable in the physics process function, above the line where we add the wander steering. Play the game one last time. The bro wanders around the map, but cannot exceed the limits of the enclosure zone. He also has the avoid obstacles steering, so he dodges the rocks too. And that's all for today. I hope you liked the video, thanks for watching, and see you in the next video.